Who is your Marcus Van? A go-getter, somebody that stands out from the rest, somebody that you can't tell me no. Nobody can tell me no. I'm gonna figure out how to make it a yes. And just somebody that just wanna be bigger than life itself.
Down in Atlanta, stayed at the centerfold. That says my vent to dope. You should have seen it. Down in Atlanta, just like a van.
Came from when I had watched something like on YouTube or something that the I Am Athlete or whatever was like doing a tour, and I was like, I like to go, like just to be in that room, just to try to rub elbows.
The goal at the moment, not the problem, what's the goal?
The goal is getting the credentials, and the goal is making sure we go back home. Either getting the interview from all those guys that's on the panel, getting one.
Nah, you gotta pick one. So you want one or you want them all?
Okay, I want them all. I want the whole. Give it. I want to risk it for the biscuit.
Who the team? So we got Pac, of course, which you know that's you, the Mr. Focus. We got Raquel, you know, the journalist, aka Raquel, the writer. And then we got Luda, aka the shooter, but he couldn't make it for this trip. Raquel had a plug out there to do our photos, so she ended up making that happen.
We need to have something secure, but no one was responding. I kept calling a place and there were crickets. And I was like, on the cool, nervous. I'm like, making sure this wasn't a blank trip.
Lord, this trip has been one for the books. Just know that we drove all the way from Houston to Atlanta with no credentials, no passes. And here we are today, the day of the event. And it seems like God has given us the green light. Let's get it.
Which pretty much is a platform that highlights athletes about, you know, their fashion and how they put it on and things of that sort.
Right.
So this panel is so this question is for the whole panel. How have you all seen the wave of fashion transition from when you all were in the league to now?
So hold on, time out. Before you go real quick and then we transition to the answer, Pam, you go first. Who's the best dressed up here? Like not right now, but I'm talking about overall.
And that was a pivotal moment, because when it came down for me to ask that question, I was not expecting the audience to react the way that they did, even the panel to react the way that they did. And so that was just a moving moment.
If you have a stylist, that's like a rapper having a ghostwriter. That's not you.
That's not you.
That's not you. Just keep it in the book. Shout out to all the stylists that's out there. And just because you got money, that don't mean you got style. You just got a lot of money.
So when it comes to fashion, what is the best thing that represents who you are?
I think it's the confidence.
Is in creating a platform. That's the one thing I've learned from Brandon Marshall, is don't take no for an answer.
In our best lives. And the last thing is tribe. I never seen a pro athlete make it to the top without a team around them. So you got to make sure you have a nice little tribe. That could be 2-3 people. So those 5 things is like my keys to success for life.
Well, thank you so much. Well, it's a wrap, y'all.
Some of the stuff that I'm doing, it's really getting me out of my comfort zone and out of my shell. So I walk in, I see people like loading in and they're like, hi, can I help you? I was like, yes, I'm looking for somebody that's a part of the I Am Athlete. And he actually walked over and I just started to just give him insight and just say, hey, you know, we've been trying to secure media credentials and we would love to feature, you know, the panel within Fashion League Styles. I gave him a rundown of what Fashion League Styles was. And he was like, oh, okay, cool. And then he pointed me in the direction of pretty much the tour manager. And we locked in with her and it was just cool. I got her contact. She was asking where we were sitting at. And I was like, all right, bet, cool. So at that moment, a sigh of relief happened, because I was like, okay, we're getting somewhere. She told me that it was a potential for an interview, but she didn't clear anything. So I was like, okay, we gotta be ready to go. Because at any moment, she can call, and I wanted to be ready for that moment. So that's how that morning or that afternoon went.
She was getting crazy. Oh my God,
she'd be crazy, bro. When that happened, like, I don't know, like, almost everybody had cleared out, and getting that interview, like, I knew that interview was gonna be historical for my career. It was gonna be major for my career. And I felt like that was just gonna be, his interview was gonna be my stepping stone to get to my next level of what I'm trying to do.
Yeah. Imagine if I never would've took a risk. Anyone ride with me, my brother ain't have a pot to piss. I won't ever see my niggas again, I gotta reminisce. No weapon formed against me, shall prosper, I swear I hope they miss. Why I gotta be like that? Neighborhood poor, they say they need that crack. Listy gone, I can't never get my nigga back. Nobody to vent, why I put my feelings in these tracks. Came a long way from the bar, I got a stunt, no